And thanks for joining us today on Around the Peninsula. I'm Maria Sorreo. We are here at Peninsula High School, where we will introduce to you the 2017 varsity baseball team.
We are kind of, we're known as, is probably coming into the year, is probably more of an offensive ball club, but I think, you know, for us to get to this point, you know, the pitching and the defense has really played a big part too. And so I think, you know, we've shown that we can win games in a variety of ways. You know, we can score a lot of runs. We've also won some tight ball games, some one run ball games, low scoring games. So that's the thing I've been happiest, the most happy about is that, you know, the versatility in terms of, you know, the team, you know, overall.
What kind of things at this level, especially maybe even seniors or anybody on varsity, what are they learning that maybe they have been working on that didn't quite get, now they are?
Well, I think the big thing, you know, that we've preached is come into practice with an attitude and an energy and an enthusiasm every day to get better, you know, and to have, you know, a focus of something that they want to work on individually, but also collectively as a team. And so, you know, we give that kind of feedback to them. Hey, I think you might need to focus on this from an individual standpoint, but from a team standpoint, really, it's about paying attention and doing the little things, you know, and we really tried to put a premium and a focus on, you know, that one or two plays in a game that sometimes determine the outcome. And, you know, that can shift, you know, a season from, you know, a team that's, you know, 500 like we've been the last couple years. We've talked a lot about some of the things that we need to clean up as a program in those, you know, tight games, those one-run games. And I think to this point, you know, we've done a good job of that. We just got to continue to grow and continue to do that.
Like, guys at this level too are very dedicated to playing baseball. Do you find that most of the your student athletes play only baseball, or they play other sports as well?
No, we encourage the kids to play, you know, multiple sports. And you know, if they are baseball only, it's, you know, from our standpoint, that the advantage is that, you know, in the off season we really, you know, we have a strong strength and conditioning program, and we really believe in getting the kids strong physically for the rigors of the season. But if we don't have them, I know that in other sports they're doing many of the similar things, and there's also the cross-training effect, and also, you know, they're not burning out, you know, if they're able to play other sports. And so, no, we encourage that. You know, I think the only time that there's ever, you know, the feedback from the coaching staff, it's if a kid wants to play at the next level, you know, are you, you know, dividing time between two sports where you're maybe, you know, what if you're good in two sports but maybe not good enough to play at the next level? Do you have to make a decision somewhere in your junior, senior year, like, to focus on one? But I think it's more of like a counselor type role. I mean, at the end of the day, it's the choice of the, you know, the athlete and the parents to, you know, to collectively make a decision. And we like to kind of play a role in that, but it's nothing where we're like mandating, you know, that you got to play baseball only or anything like that. We encourage them playing multiple sports.
I've been playing it for about 4 years now. I started in high school and, you know, I just fell in love with the game. I used to play soccer, basketball, and a little swimming too.
And what do you think that you sort of have gained the most from, especially swimming, which is a kind of an all-around sport, to get you better with playing baseball now?
Well, I used to do the backstroke, and that really kind of helped me with, like, my stamina. And, like, baseball is really a stamina sport where you have to, you know, kind of, like, pitching-wise, you just have to, like, be able to, like, pitch a whole game, and the stamina really helps there.
And what position do you play?
I play pitcher and first base.
And did you ever play anything else? Or
I used to play shortstop, and then, you know, I hit my growth spurt, and that kind of went out the door. So, yeah.
Okay, and what do you like to work on most when you're out here, especially during the season?
Hitting, usually, you know, like, halfway through the season, you start to lose your swing a little bit, and kind of, like, got to tune it in every single day, you know, make sure it's in tune, and, you know, keep hitting really well.
Now, Nick, now that I know that you have played other sports, tell me how long you've been playing baseball and why you chose it as one of your sports.
I'm playing baseball for probably around 10 years. I just play because I just love the game, and it's just a good time.
Okay. And so tell me the other sports that you also play and how they kind of help you with your baseball.
Yeah, I also play basketball here at the school, and just every day, like, coming to practice and just having, like, the mentality of the practice and play just helps every day.
Okay. Tell me this season what your coaches are kind of trying to implement for you guys.
Just to come out here and work hard every day, just trying to get better as a team.
And what do you work on specifically in your game, do you think, from year to year to get better?
I just kind of work, I guess, all around on, like, hitting, fielding, pitching, just kind of whatever I think I need to help me.
I've been playing baseball for 10 years now, since I was 6. And I don't know, my dad and my brother just got me into it. And I've always had a great time playing.
Did you play any other sports or?
I played some football when I was younger, but nothing really serious to where it became a big thing for me.
Okay. How do you keep in shape during the off season when you're not here?
During the off season, when we're not on the field, we're always in the weight room. I mean, we get in every once in a while when we can. Okay. And yeah.
And what position do you play?
I'm the shortstop.
Okay. Did you ever play any other positions or want to play any other positions?
Yeah, I did play catcher.
Okay. And what do you try to work on specifically in your game from season to season?
Each year it's just picking out something new and different. Just this year I've been working on my fielding a little bit more, a little more of my glove ability.
Okay. All right. And what are your expectations for the team this year? You guys are doing pretty well.
Yeah, I mean, we just take it one game at a time, and we just put together a few runs here and there, and we've been doing really well. Played since I was 6 years old, and once I picked up a wiffle bat and hit a wiffle ball, and I just fell in love with the sport.
Did you ever play any other sports?
I played soccer and basketball mostly.
Okay. How do you think that the skills that you learned in those two sports sort of help you with baseball?
It helped me to know how to work with the team and sportsmanship and all that. Just really helped me play with these guys.
Okay. What message is your coach trying to implement to you guys this year?
I think he's really trying to help us deal with adversity. Okay. And, you know, no matter what hits us, we can just overtake any challenge that stands in our way.
Okay. What do you like to work on in your individual game from year to year?
I just really work on all parts of it, not really one part. Just keep working, just keep getting better no matter what it takes.
I've been playing baseball since 2003, I remember from my little baseball card, so that's 14 years. I chose baseball because my dad, he played baseball when he went to college at Stanford, and he always kind of helped me out with that, so I felt like I was the most knowledgeable. I actually tried water polo junior year and wasn't great, so decided to come back to baseball and have a good time.
Okay. What do you train, or how do you train in the off season? What kind of things do you tend to work on?
Oh, I just go to the gym and just try to work on getting stronger. Also try to work on ground balls in my swing, because during the season there's not a whole lot of time to like fine tune. So I try to get muscle memory down, so during the season I can do my best.
Okay. And then what message do your coaches implement to you guys to kind of focus on?
Oh, well, for hitting, our coach, he's really helped me this year. All he's told me is hit the ball out. So it really just helped me this year, free swinging, and I really contribute that to my good hitting this year. And then the other coaches, just very positive teamwork, commitment, and just working hard for one another.
See the ball, hit the ball, right?
Yeah.
All right. What position do you play?
I play second base.
Okay. And did you ever play any other positions or?
I've played shortstop in the past. I've pitched like twice ever in all 4 years here, but mostly second base.
How does that work? I mean, I guess after a while, you played for a really long time. Do the coaches just know like what you're best at, or?
Well, I mean, we work out all together during the off season, so the coaches get a chance to see us at all the positions, and someone else is better at shortstop and I was better at second base, so we just worked out that way.
I've been playing baseball for around 13 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
And tell me the other sports you play and how that sort of helps you with baseball.
So I play football, and I think that helps with like giving your arm some time off.
Yeah.
So yeah, and I also play basketball just for fun, like not for the high school team or anything, and it just helps me stay in shape, I guess.
So you like to stay busy as an all-around athlete.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, and then what position do you play?
For baseball, I play pitcher and third.
And did you always play those positions, or?
Yeah, I mean, since Little League, I've been playing third, and it's just my home, honestly.
Okay, what kind of things throughout the season do you like to work on in your game?
In the off season, you like to make bigger adjustments, but once you're in season, you want to make smaller adjustments, and honestly, that's what I've been doing, and it's worked pretty well.
I've been playing baseball for over about 10 years, and I just stuck with it because that's what I was best at, I guess.
Okay. What do you like to work on in the off season to kind of prepare you for the regular season?
Definitely strength and conditioning. I like to go to the weight room a lot with my friends and just work out.
Okay. What position do you play?
I'm a catcher.
Okay. And did you always play catcher, or were you try other things, or?
Yeah, I was usually either somewhere in the infield, and I just ended up being a catcher in like Little League and stuck with it.
Okay, so catcher, you kind of have to know what's going on at all times. Do you enjoy that, or?
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot to think about. There's a lot of thought. This is the big thought process behind it, but yeah, I do enjoy it.
Okay.
The challenge.
I was going to ask you what the biggest challenge was, but that's probably it.
Yeah, that's the challenge. Yeah.
Okay, all right. And how difficult is it to learn the pitchers and everything you have to do to communicate with them?
basketball. I've been working with the same guys for past couple of years, so I mean, at this point, I've gotten used to it. So I mean, it's not that difficult. Yeah,
okay.
Gotten used.
And then, what is the message that the coaches are trying to pretty much implement to you guys this year?
Give it all you got. Practice. Don't slack off at all. Just work hard.
I've been playing baseball since I was about 6 or 7 years old, and I kind of just got enrolled in it first because my dad just wanted me to play, and I've been playing ever since. And as I got older, I started to love it more and more. And it's just something I became good at the more I got experience and playing time. And it's just been my sport of choice ever since.
Did you ever play any other sports? Or?
I played tennis and soccer kind of middle school, but I didn't really like the running in soccer. And in tennis, I wasn't too good at, so I kind of stuck with baseball.
Okay. And what position do you play?
Third base.
And did you ever play anything else, or how did you kind of settle in at that spot?
Yeah, I played a little bit of shortstop and second base last year. And I started off second base this year too, but our third baseman got hurt, so I moved in there to fill in that spot, and I've been there ever since.
What's been the biggest challenge for you at third?
I think it's a little bit closer to plate, and so I've been kind of trying to struggle between playing in and playing back. You know, some balls been getting really hit hard to me, and that kind of gets a little tough sometimes, and the bunt sometimes is a little tough as well. So I think that's been the biggest struggle for me.
And what is the message that the coaches are trying to implement to you guys this year?
Accountability, I would say, you know, and hard work, definitely. We have a lot of talent, and I think for us not to get like complacent and think, oh, we're good, is been the biggest challenge. So we keep working every day, you know, to keep winning games and playing well.
I've been playing baseball since I was 3 years old, and I had a Yankees teddy bear in my crib when I was born, like 6 weeks
old. Please tell me that your family's from New York.
Yeah, both my parents were born in New York.
Good deal. And tell me what position you play.
I play outfield.
Did you ever play any other position, or how did you kind of settle with that?
I used to catch, and then freshman year I got moved to the outfield, and okay. I've been there since.
And what are the biggest challenges when you're in the outfield?
I think your first step, getting a good read on the ball. Sometimes it looks like it's not going very far, and it's over your head. Sometimes it's, you know, in the gap, and sometimes you just get a bad read, especially this ballpark. It's tough to pick up, especially in right field.
I think people think it's really easy, but if you stand in the middle out there or side to side, it's like, where's the ball? It's so small.
Yeah, it is. And yeah, it's pretty small, and you have to have a good first step. And yeah.
Okay. And then tell me what your coaches are trying to sort of implement the message to you guys this year.
Well, I think it's a lot about baseball, but it's a lot more about life. I think that it's a lot of accountability, dependability, you know. People have to be able to count on you in baseball, and people have to be able to count on you in life.
I've been playing baseball since I was 5 years old, and I play it just because, I don't know, I think it's the best of all sports out there, and it just, something about it just makes it so interesting and so fun to me that I just have enjoyed playing it, and hopefully I can continue in the future.
Okay, when you've played as long as you have, what do you find that you work on from season to season to get better?
I think I just try to work on having a good work ethic and constantly putting in effort and time to making myself a better player, and hopefully if I do that constantly, then I can reach my full potential.
Okay. What position do you play?
I play right field and first base.
And what are the biggest challenges to play outfield and infield?
I'd say that you have to go to both positions in practice, and so you have to divide your time up, so some people might get more practice time in other places than you, but I think it's good to be well-rounded, and that having multiple positions gives you better chances to be in the lineup.
Okay. And then what's the message the coaches are trying to implement this year for you guys?
I think they're just trying to implement that we work hard and don't try to do too much. Just be ourselves. Don't try to be someone we're not. And we want to work hard, but play the game the right way.
I've been playing baseball since I was 3. And I chose it because I've been going to Dodger games since I was about 1.
Okay.
So,
before you could remember, you were going to Dodger games.
Yeah, okay. Exactly.
All right. Tell me what position you play.
I play center field.
Okay. Did you always play center field, or did you kind of move around and settle there? Or
I used to play shortstop. Okay. But then once I got to high school, I decided to go to center field.
Okay. And what's the biggest challenge out there?
It's probably reading the ball when it's really well hit.
What's the message the coaches are trying to sort of implement to you guys this year?
Probably just work hard and do your best and have fun at the same time.
So I've been playing baseball since I was 5.
Wow, okay.
And then football since I was about 10.
Okay, what kind of a challenge is that to be, you know, a two-player sport? And, like, how does one help you with the other one, do you think?
I think they're a lot of different mentalities with doing it. So baseball is a very different sport than football, just the pace of the game and how intense you have to be. With baseball, it's a bunch of really intense moments, and football, it's a sustained intensity over the course of the game.
And then what do you work on most from year to year playing baseball, like in your own game, do you think?
I just work on getting more technical and trying to improve how I play during the game.
Okay. What is the message that the coach is trying to implement to you guys this year, do you think?
It's really to treat every practice like it's a game and work with game like intensity all the time.
I've been playing baseball since I was around 2-3 years old in T-ball, and I chose it because my grandfather played for the Phillies and my mom and dad also played, so okay. I was just brought into it.
So you're a family sport?
Yes.
Okay, definitely. All right. Tell me from year to year, since you started so young, what you like to work on in your game, especially as you get older, because obviously you're stronger and you're better.
Yeah, definitely versatility. You know, I like to play every position on the field, be very versatile on the team.
Okay. And so I was going to ask you that next, what position you play, how have you sort of worked all the way around?
Yeah, so I used to just play everywhere. This year I've kind of settled in left field, okay. So playing there a lot.
What's the biggest challenge playing left?
Reading the spin off the ball and the wind, probably, biggest.
And do you ever play any other sports? Or?
No.
And what do you work on specifically in the off season when you're not out here every day?
I usually just play some games with a club team and just try to get ready, strengthen.
Okay. How many swings do you take a day?
Oh, gosh. A lot. A lot.
Do you ever count them?
No, don't count them, but it definitely shows on our hands.
Before school, after school, or?
After school, at practice, okay. And then after practice.
Okay, all right. So, at home too, or?
Yes, definitely.
Wow.
Everywhere.
I've been playing baseball for as long as I can remember, since I was a little kid, and I just instantly fell in love with the game. As my father and my grandfather, and just throughout my life, has always kind of instilled that in me, and just kind of made it a big part of my life. And my father actually was blessed to play in college and then to go on and get drafted. So it was always just kind of a part of my life that I loved.
It sounds like a family business almost.
It is. It really is.
All right. You and I talked about the fact that you're going to walk on in college and try to play. Since you played for a really long time, what do you find that you specifically work on in your game from year to year?
Year to year, I think it's just staying consistent. I think consistency with my swing and just continuing to get stronger and work on the fundamentals, as it's easy to kind of stray away. As you know, once you get to a certain level, it's like, oh, you're already there, but then you got to keep working on it and refining those little things.
What position do you play?
I play center field.
Now, did you always play center, or?
For Little League, and actually throughout my whole life, I've actually been a shortstop, and then just last year I made the switch to center field.
What's the biggest challenge playing center?
The biggest challenge would probably be just the first reaction off the ball, just reading it off the bat and just kind of making your move whichever way. That usually tends to be the most difficult.
Kind of the captain out there too, to make sure that you know what's going on in the outfield.
Yeah, and that's something that I take pride in, and that I love to kind of have that position to get to lead the team and just to kind of make sure that everyone's in place and where they need to be for that pitch and every pitch.
And what are the coaches, what's their message to you guys this year?
This year's message is to not take anything for granted and to keep pushing. And while we may have like a few different times of just kind of a lull where we may not have a game and where we are really just focusing on practicing, that we need to take advantage of that time and to not slack off and really just take advantage of this year with so many seniors. And just to have fun, really.
Well, I've been playing baseball since I've been around 6 years old. I saw my brothers, Michael and Jacob, play. My brother Jacob actually played at the University of Arizona and then the Astros organization for a little bit, so that's been a big motivator for me to play baseball.
Coming from a baseball family, from year to year, what do you work on most in your game?
Mental part of it most. I feel like that's a very important part of the game. Mental approach is very important for me.
Okay. And then what position do you play?
I'm a pitcher.
Okay. And so did you always pitch? Did you play different positions? How did you sort of settle in that?
I've been a pitcher since I've been around 10 years old. That I was still in first baseman, but mostly a pitcher. My brother is actually a catcher, so he catches my bullpens and stuff. So that's a good experience for me. He helps me a lot through that.
I was going to ask you, the relationship between the pitcher and the catcher is so important because they basically have to read your mind, and you have to know what's going on with them as well.
Yeah, it's a big part of a pitching-catching relationship. leadership, knowing what pitches to call, what pitches I like in certain situations. Just good compatibility is very important, and hope it makes it a lot easier on the pitcher.
How long does it sort of take you guys to get that rapport?
Probably about half the season, I feel like, and then by then we're rolling. Yeah.
Okay. All right. And then tell me what the coaches are most implementing to you guys this year.
We have new coaching staff this year, so I feel like a new mental approach. I felt like in the past we were lacked in that, and I feel like they've really helped us with that mental approach by telling us in situations, like being smarter baseball team mostly.
Well, when baseball players aren't playing baseball, they're usually watching baseball. So I had to ask, who's your favorite pro team and what players do you like to watch? Favorite pro team and players you like to watch?
Okay, so this isn't going to be popular here, but I'm a San Francisco Giants fan. And yeah, so the deal was, like, if I wanted food and shelter, you know, my parents are from the Bay Area, so I was going to root for the 49ers and the Giants. That was kind of the deal. You know, I root for the Giants, and then I also root for the Toronto Blue Jays with my, you know, with my history with playing with that organization.
The Dodgers, obviously, and then I like Josh Donaldson, Justin Turner, Clayton Kershaw, obviously, yeah.
Favorite pro team and players you like to watch?
I gotta say the Angels. Well, I mean, I love Trout. I also love Kershaw, watching Kershaw pitch.
I gotta say the Cubs just because they won. Okay. I'm gonna jump on the bandwagon, right. I'm sorry.
Any favorite players you like to watch?
Yeah, I do really like to watch the Rizzo, the way he swings. He's got an approach, like he always knows his approach. That's what I love about him.
Anaheim Angels, and my favorite player to watch is Mike Trout.
Favorite pro team and players you like to watch?
My favorite pro team is the Angels. I love Andrelton Simmons at shortstop, and I love Mike Trout hitting.
My favorite team is the Dodgers, and my favorite players are probably Mike Trout and Carlos Gomez.
Tell me your favorite team, pro team, and players you like to watch.
New York Yankees. I love watching Aaron Judge play. He's just only his second year right now, but he's so good. He's incredible, yeah.
My favorite team would be the Dodgers by far. I like Gastiel Puig. I think he's having a good comeback season so far, and I hope it continues.
I know this is going to be a tough question for you, but favorite pro team and players you like to watch?
Probably the Dodgers, and my favorite players are Clayton Kershaw and then Sean Green, who I used to play.
My favorite team is the Dodgers, but my favorite people to watch are good catchers like the Molina family.
Okay, so my favorite pro team is the New York Yankees, and I love watching Sharif Othman and Bryce Harper.
I'm actually a Marlins fan, and I like Christian Yelich and Giancarlo Stanton. I feel like it's fun to watch them hit the ball.
My favorite pro team is the Angels, and my favorite player is Mike Trout.
And that will do it for today's show. A big thank you to the Panther baseball team. Good luck the rest of the way, guys. I'm Maria Sorreo, and we'll see you next time around the peninsula.